As another snowstorm begins to move into the heart of the Midwest, most locals take to their homes with blankets and warm fireplaces. A dedicated few arm themselves with shovels and snowblowers to clear their properties. Even fewer make their living out there in the cold, out in the snow. They are the snowmen.
All right, I've got my up-down cylinder. It's a little bit on the weak side, but it's also leaking pretty seriously. So whenever I park and it's a little bit wet outside, when I get done moving the truck, there's a huge rainbow on the ground, so it's leaking fluid like really there's no tomorrow. It's just what happens when plows get abused. People don't take care of them, and cylinders pitted and just mess up the seals.
So I've got another one. A friend of mine gave me.
I'll be putting it on. But we got another big storm hitting today, so we were talking about 18 inches about 4 days ago. And it's come down to 6-8, and now it's gonna be somewhere around the 4 range, they're saying. South of the city is probably gonna get more like 10 or 12. About to replace the cylinder, up down lift cylinder, because the seals are leaking real bad. So I got one from a friend of mine, and it's actually a smaller cylinder, but it's faster, and that's what I was hoping it was. Beautiful, brand new parts. I love new parts.
Yeah. But you pretty much have rebuilt.
I know, pretty much. Yeah. Pretty cool. Yeah, a lot of you buy an abused vehicle or abused stuff. Wow.
Well, the biggest thing that deteriorated this plow was he left it outside.
I know.
Because all the pitting gets on those cylinders, the seals on the cylinders get exposed more and brittle, you know, the springs rust out, and once they start rusting that bad, then they don't have the tension that they need.
Now I've got three brand new rams on my truck. Two side ones cost me like $350.
Got but the new also attachment points.
Yeah, new attachment points. Man, I'll rebuild this whole
thing. New jack.
Yep. The cool thing I like about these particular rams, these new side ones, are the, I forget what they call them, but they're that black stuff. They're not the chrome, so they don't pit. Like the side ones I had before were pitted when I first started using the plow this year, but the chrome started flaking off, and then that's when it really started taking the seals.
Yeah, because then it's like sandpaper on those seals.
Yeah, exactly. Like sandpaper on those seals.
Sorry, I'm still getting.
We just got through putting the cylinder back on. The new one, smaller, it's supposed to be faster. I'm excited about it. Hopefully it's faster. Let's go test it out. I'm gonna put it through its paces. Okay, everything's good to go, ready for tonight's storm. Okay, so we really got dumped on last night. Actually, the snowfall rates were like 1 to 2 inches an hour, and we've got about 8 inches out there. It came down fast and hard. Now it's done, sun's coming out. Tim's on his way. This is gonna be Tim's first day, full day working with me. He has worked before. He did an ice storm where he worked a couple of hours, you know, maybe 2 hours with me. This is now gonna be 15 to 20 hours out there. So we'll see how he does and if he comes back after that.
Okay, so basically I'm just gonna go through the rundown. The first thing on most of the houses is shovel in front of the garage.
Like how many feet?
So just like a shovel width, you know, one and a half shovel widths. But you gotta shovel in front of the garage, push it out so that I can, that's what you start with. So immediately when we pull up, I'll stop, you get out, grab a shovel, go up to the garage, shovel it all out into the driveway.
Yeah.
So that I can come, pull up, and then back drag. And then after, you know, after you shovel that, then go to the walkways, if we have the walkways on that house. There'll be some houses where we don't do the walkways, but we'll still get out and shovel the little strip in front of the garage.
Yeah.
And then also, you always want to make sure that you know exactly where the plow is at all times. Because there's a lot of blind spots where I can't see you.
Yeah.
So it's so important that you pay attention to where I am and stay out of the way of the plow. Because otherwise you could get hurt or killed. You don't want to slow me down at all. So like if you're getting a sidewalk and it comes right up to a driveway, wait until I make my pass.
Yeah.
Don't just stand in the way, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And do that. So just always be watching where the plow is and getting out of the way of the plow.
Have to be aware of people that are all around you, and they come sneaking up on you sometimes.
So I got a call from Caitlin while we were plowing about an incident that happened at one of the local hospitals here in the area. Plow guy was clearing the lot. It was really early in the morning while the snow was still falling. The snow weights were really heavy at that time. And a nurse was walking into work and he backed up over her, didn't even know he hit her, and started dragging her. And after some time, he realized what had happened, and by that time, it was too late.
51-year-old nurse Diane Shogren, driving through another winter storm, had just arrived to work at Advocate Good Shepherd Hospital in Barrington. She was walking through the parking lot around 5:30 this morning.
It was heavily snowing this morning, and the visibility was very limited.
In those terrible conditions, a man plowing the lot in a red pickup truck backed up the vehicle, accidentally hitting Shogren. Her co-workers ran outside and rushed her into the emergency room, but the married mother died a short time later. Tonight, the hospital providing counseling to her family, her co-workers, and the plow driver. They also say they'll review their safety procedures.
We will take all steps necessary to enhance the safety of our campus.
As the investigation continues, police do say the truck's equipment appeared to be working properly this morning.
The amber lights, the backup lights, and the backup alarm were working on the vehicle.
The snowplow driver is also a hospital employee. There is no indication that drugs or alcohol were involved, and police tell me that no charges have been filed in this case.
So after I heard the news, I immediately called Tori to let him know what had happened.
Oh no, really? Oh my God! Oh, you mean he actually ran over her? Well, he's, you know, he's messed up. Yeah, no, thanks for telling them. Makes me be more alert. Twist my body around when I'm trying to plow.
Just sad. I would not want to have to live with that as a plow guy, knowing that I ran over somebody and killed them.
Yeah. He probably didn't even know it was dragging, which he didn't, because you can't always tell when you're riding. A lot of the times it's very bumpy when you're hitting the snow and hitting, you know, different areas that the truck shakes from that, so you can't even tell if you could have just hit somebody or what.
That happened to me this morning. I'm in the middle of freaking nowhere, and this girl comes around me, and I'm like, you know, and she will come walking around me, the back of the truck. I'm like, you have got to be kidding. Are you stupid?
It's unsettling when you hear of stuff like that happening. You know, somebody getting hit in a parking lot by a plow truck. I mean, I know people get hit by cars all the time, but safety is supposed to be such a huge thing in the industry, and not that this guy wasn't. I mean, he had all his lights working, he had all his alarms working, but she didn't see him, and he didn't see her, and somebody's dead because of it, and you kind of put yourself in that situation. For me personally, I think about that's somebody's husband that hit her. I mean, obviously her family lost her, but that's a plow driver. That's someone in my husband's shoes has caused a death. I mean, accidents happen, but still, that guy's got to go home and live with that.
You know, hearing news like this really shook me. As a plow guy, it hits close to home, and you know, it makes you kind of think about your procedures and re-examine the way you go about plowing.
There's so much going on that you're trying to pay attention to when you're plowing, and you can't always see everything and everyone that's walking behind you. You know, people can walk pretty quick, come in your path, and you're just going back and forth, back and forth. So I guess the food for thought to take away from this one for anybody you know, who sees a plow guy plowing, if you're not a plow guy, just assume they can't see you, because it might cost you your life if you think they can see you and then they can't. And for the plow guys out there, it's pay more attention. There's always spots you can't see, but sometimes maybe just slow down and pay attention, and hopefully that never happens to anyone else.
down ram, I got smaller bore, so it goes up way faster. It makes plowing so much easier.
This particular house, I had just gotten it as an account the previous storm, and hadn't been taken care of all winter long, so there was a tremendous buildup of rock hard snow, so I had to get crazy with it and peel it off of the sidewalk. It was a flat out mess. I just ended up shoving it all up into the yard and hoped for a sunny day so it would clean it off.
I moved it back a good 10 feet. I love plowing. Great thing. We just made a whole bunch of green cabbage.
You know, I think it's very important that you're aware of your surroundings at all times. You know, Ryan preaches it all the time. I say it as well. Just know where you are. Visualize where you are, where the curbs are, where the mailboxes are, where the people are for sure. You know, people come up next to you all the time. Be aware. Be aware, be aware. You can't distress that enough. You know, sometimes we're plowing and we're backing up and people are coming at an adjacent street and they just don't stop. Up here in Chicago, they just don't stop. They don't care about you sometimes. They gotta get to work.
So as a shovel rat, you tend to start to get in a rhythm where you're just always looking down, and that's not a good thing. You always wanna be looking up, paying attention, because you're essentially a partner with that truck. So that truck plowing and you're shoveling alongside of it. To always be aware where that truck is at all times and know that he can't always see you at all times because of his vision being restricted.
As a shovel rat, talking to my other shovel rats, being careful while we're out there and we're around the truck, because I know I get a little too close to the truck sometimes. I see where he's going, or I think I know where Ryan's going, and I try and shovel right along next to it to try and make my job easier, but you gotta be careful. You don't always know where the driver is gonna go. You might think they're gonna be back dragging, but they might actually be taking another pass. Being cautious is worth it, even if you have to lose a little bit of time. At the end of the day, it's you're still alive, so you're making green cabbage. It's worth it to just be careful and to take those extra safety precautions. And you're still gonna get a paycheck. Just go a little bit slower and make sure you're doing things right to keep yourself safe.
You can never, ever, ever think that the plow guy knows where you are. You know, if it's things are moving so fast and moving forward and backwards and you're tilting the plow one way or the other, there's always a chance that he doesn't see you, or you look like, if you're standing still, you look like a tree, or you look like a mailbox, you know, something that's stationary, and you just have to, cannot think that the plow guy sees you.
I've got generally a bad attitude about how Ryan tells me to be around the truck. In my head, I'm invincible, and he's not gonna hit me, he knows where I am, so it adds a perspective to me to be more cautious and acquiesce to some of his requests for safety equipment and things like that that I've been shrugging off for a long time.
If I take anything away from this whole situation, it's always, whether you're plowing or not, or even if I'm not out shoveling, always be conscious of your surroundings, because it may not even be a plow truck, it can be anything else like that. You can get hit by a car. I mean, you just have to be conscious, because you can't control what the other person's doing. You can only control what you're doing.
for the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping, and I brought some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. The fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbye. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.